I'll throw on these socks. Right, so welcome to the entrance of the cave. Now the name of this cave is Paul Love, which means the black hole. So if you look in there, you can kind of understand why. So just a bit of information, the first bit, about 15-20 metres, is a bit of a crawl, you're down your hunkers. But it does open up again, so don't feel like the whole trip you're down in a hunker position. It opens up into a little challenge where you can perfectly walk. Okay, so this is the entrance to Paul Dove Cave. Now, the first bit here does look a bit scary, it looks a bit confined, but after about 10 metres here, it's going to open up into a whole new world down here. We're going to see stalactites, stalagmites, columns, etc. So, there's options all the way through. You're not entirely crawling, there's options to crawl for the more sporting people, and then it opens up into a whole new chamber. So, we'll rock on another bit here. So there's two options here. We can go down around the channel here where it does open up into a little chamber. Or for the few of us that are definitely more adventurous, there's a nice little shuttle through this little passageway here. So it's a little tunnel, it's a Superman, and then use your elbows like you see. It goes on for about 15 to 18 feet, and we meet your own far side as you go across the road. It's a nice little introduction to Kevin. Anybody up for it? Yeah. Go for it. We'll meet you to the far side. Yeah, the both of them lead into one. So it kind of gives you an idea of how stalactites are formed. Okay. So if you look where you start off, they're called the straws. Along the wall, they're called flowstones. Now it's deposits of calcite that's left behind. And you see how it's different colours. If it's brown, that's just iron coming in and being locked in from the side outside. And then there's darker red, that's manganese. That's from the roots of the trees and the above. So anytime you see a darkish reddish brown, you know there's a forest up there. Yeah, it makes it look pretty cool for nature. So, geologists love caves because they can tell an awful lot about what was going on in the environment maybe thousands of years ago. So, the most obvious thing are these little dimples here. Okay, so they're called scallops. And what they represent is the eddies, the movement in the water. So, if you look at this slide zone here, for instance, you see the smaller ones and then there's bigger ones. So, what the smaller ones represent is fast moving water. So that could be the glacier melt during the ice age, etc. The bigger ones did show slow moving water, which could be a plantation, a river, or anything like that. Also very good for cables. If you you ever run out of light and you lose direction. So if you rub your hand one way as opposed to the opposite way, you find that it's rougher one way. So what happens is the water smooths it out. So you want to go the rough way. If you find the source of the water, you find your exit. So very helpful for cavers and for geologists. We've got that to this country, so we'll get it going.